All right, in this video, I'm going to go over the velocity versus time graph and what information we can get from the line that is drawn on the velocity versus time graph. You remember in the previous video, I went over the position versus time graph, and the position versus time graph, the slope of the line on that graph was the velocity. And this is the velocity versus time graph, and obviously these lines all have slopes, but the meaning of that slope is very different. It does not equal the velocity, obviously. So let's just go over really quick what's not going on with the object that's represented on this graph. You remember we just said that still this is motion in one dimension. So a lot of people will still think that, okay, we're going on a flat section and then we go up a hill and across a flat section and down the other side of the hill. This is just motion in one dimension. So once again, we're just moving in a straight line. We might be moving back and forth, but we're not moving up and down or turning corners or anything like that. And you can see from here, all we have is the velocity. This tells us our velocity, and this tells us the time, or the time at which this velocity occurs. And we're just talking about the motion of an object in one dimension. Now, let's just look really carefully. We can get some information just by looking really carefully what is on here. Here's the velocity. The velocity is constant over this section. Then you can see our speed increases from 6 to 12, and then it's constant again, and then it decreases from 12 to 3. Now all of these velocities are positive, so we're always going in the positive direction. And so you can see it's constant here, then we increase our speed, and then we have a constant velocity, and then we decrease our speed, but it's always in the positive direction. Now let's just look at the slope, as I said at the beginning, and see what information we can get from the slope of that line, and then we'll look at the lines, each section, in more detail. So you'll remember, once again, that the slope is the rise over the run. Okay? And you remember that means it's the change in the y over the change in the x. And in this case, we have our velocities, and our velocities are measured in meters per second. So the units for our change in y is meters per second. And our units on our x-axis, we would measure in seconds. And you remember that meters per second is simplified to meters per second squared. And those, of course, are the units for, that's right, acceleration. Okay, so on this graph, the velocity versus time graph, the slope equals the acceleration. On the previous video, the position in time, the slope was the velocity. But in this case, you got to remember the velocity in time, the slope is the acceleration. Now let's just look at each section and see how it all kind of works out nice and neat for us. So this line has no slope. Therefore, it has no acceleration. Zero acceleration. That means all of these velocities are constant. All of these velocities are positive. You see it's always positive six meters per second. So that means our velocity is positive throughout, which means we're always going in the positive direction, but the velocity in this case is constant because there's no acceleration. All right, that's section number one. Now let's look at section number two. In section number two, the slope of this line is positive, and as we know, the slope is the acceleration. So in this case, the acceleration is positive. Now, which way are we going, or what's our velocity? Well, you can see that once again, all of these numbers, all of these velocities are positive. 3, 6, 9, 12, there's no negatives. That means we're always going in the positive direction, and that means that our velocity is positive. So now, here we have the case where our acceleration vector points in the positive direction. This tells us our direction. Our velocity vector points in the positive direction. That means they're both pointing in the same direction. And what does that mean about our speed? It means that we are speeding up. And you can see that we're going from 6 to 12. All right, across here, this is number 3. This is similar to number 1 again. Our acceleration is 0. All of our velocities are positive, but because the acceleration is 0, that means we're going with a constant speed. Section number 4. Now, this is a little interesting. You can see that this line has a negative slope, and the slope is the acceleration. So, therefore, the acceleration on this one is negative. The acceleration vector points in the negative direction. The sign of those tells us our direction. Now, but once again, you'll notice that all of our velocities are positive. That means we're going in the positive direction. So velocity is positive. So what does it mean if we have a negative acceleration vector, a velocity vector that's pointing in the opposite direction or in the positive direction? Well, if the acceleration vector and the velocity vector point in the opposite direction, that means we're slowing down. And you can see that with our speeds, we have constant speed, speeding up, constant speed, and slowing down. It all works out if we look at our slopes and our velocities. All right? So now let's go through and calculate the acceleration across number four. Here is our initial position in time, and here's our final position in time. So we can pretty easily calculate the acceleration across number four. The acceleration, as you remember, is the velocity final minus the velocity initial over the change in time. And in this case, where we have our final velocity, which is right here, is 3 meters. Oops. 3 meters per second. And our initial velocity is 12 meters per second. And the change in time is 4 seconds, from 8 to 12 seconds is 4 seconds. And if we do that, we get that our acceleration is minus 2.25 meters per second squared. Okay, so across number four, that's our acceleration, and it is negative. You can see that the acceleration here is negative because the slope is negative and we are slowing down, but all of our velocities, all our speeds are positive, okay? So once again, let's just review what this graph, we just read the graph. Constant velocity, 6 meters per second, increase our speed from 6 to 12, stay at 12, and then decrease our speed from 12 to 3 meters per second. And you can see that it all works out whether we do the calculations or whether we look at the signs and the slopes of our acceleration and then the sign of our velocity. All right? So that's velocity versus time. Be very careful when you look at the graph and see what's presented. And remember, velocity and time, the slope is the acceleration. And on the position and time graph, the slope of the position versus time graph is the velocity. All right. Thank you.